I want to thank everybody for coming out on this cold January day and braving through the weather. I know many of you came from long distances to join us this morning. We had an early morning start. We started the day off with a tribal leadership breakfast at the governor's mansion with Governor Daugaard and the First Lady, and that was a good conversation. And then we followed that with a three-hour listening session that we just finished up, and we have some folks still coming in from that meeting this morning. So it's already been a good day. So I want to say greetings to all our friends and relatives here today. Midakiopi, Ambetuwash Day. It's a very good day, and it's good to be with you today. I just want to give you a quick background on the purpose of the State Tribal Relations Day. The reason why we started having State Tribal Relations Day at the Capitol was because we wanted to increase the number of forums and opportunities that state and tribal leaders have to engage in meaningful dialogue so that we can learn more about each other's governance and so that we can establish more effective partnerships. It was also important that we tried to create not only a one-time dialogue, but an ongoing dialogue, a dialogue that goes beyond an event, but becomes a process and an effective process to problem solving and creating solutions, not only on the reservations, but off the reservation. We also wanted to create this day because we felt it was important from a state perspective to sit back and listen. Gone are the days of going out to the reservation saying, this is what we think needs to happen. In this new era of state-tribal relations, it's about listening. It's about listening to what the tribes need, what the tribes think needs to happen, and then we as a state responding by saying, how can we help? How can we partner to make those things possible? And we also wanted to create an annual theme to the State Tribal Relations Day. Last year it was on economic development. And somebody asked earlier, is there been any follow through with last year's listening session? I'm glad to report that there has been ongoing talks and the dialogue continues on tribal economic development. And I suspect that there will be similar follow through as a result of this year's theme on housing. We had a wonderful listening session, great testimony, lots of wisdom, lots of knowledge shared. I want to thank all those that participated. But I just want to say to everybody, and I want to say welcome to all the legislators, all of our tribal officials, the general public, everybody that's here, our federal officials from federal agencies. I just want to say that none of this would be possible if it wasn't for the initiative of our governor. The governor creating this cabinet-level department and really creating the opportunity for us to have this day. And with that, I would like to introduce to you our governor, Governor Dennis Daugaard.
Thank you. It's all right. Good afternoon. Thank you for that welcome. And welcome to Pierre and our State Tribal Relations Day. I want to start by thanking everyone for coming today because we can get to know each other as friends and develop good government-to-government relations only if we get together and only if we talk and get to know one another. So I appreciate that you've taken time, each one of you, to come and spend some time with us and with each other. I hope this is a good day for everyone and that we can continue to do this in the future. I also want to thank JR and his staff for helping organize this and for all the hard work they do on behalf of the tribes and the people of South Dakota. South Dakota is the only state with a cabinet-level tribal relations secretary, and I think this distinguishes us from our regional neighbors, and I hope it indicates the priority that the state of South Dakota is placing upon good relations with tribal governments. Would JR's staff please stand or wave as I call out your name? Carrie Westover is the executive secretary for JR. Carrie, where are you? Over there. Thank you, Carrie. I saw Carrie's husband is here to make sure you behave, apparently. Chad, we know you're out there. Also, Andrea Rosenberg, intergovernmental relations liaison. Andrea, right back here. Thank you, Andrea. Also, Janet Jessup, who's a policy analyst. Janet. and Michelle Faw, our grant writer. Michelle, thank you for being here. Thank you for all your work. After our program today, we're going to have lunch, and that's being prepared by the Lower Brule ProStart Culinary Arts Program. And this program is only one of 10 like it in the nation, in the state, and competes across the U.S. against other ProStart programs. In fact, this year, the group is currently raising funds to compete in Ohio and Wisconsin. So let's thank them for their work, the members of the Lower Brule ProStart Culinary Arts Program, and we'll taste test later. State Tribal Relations Day is designed to share the successes that are coming out of Indian Country today with state legislators and also to share projects and initiatives that benefit all of South Dakota. This year, the focus, as JR mentioned, is on housing and aims to share both the need for housing in South Dakota as well as each tribe's initiatives to meet the needs of its people. On each reservation, waiting lists for housing are often very lengthy. We know there's a great need for affordable housing on and off the reservation, but today let's talk about what's being done to address these needs so we can work together to solve these problems. There are 9 tribal housing authorities in this state, one for each tribe, and each authority is working to meet the housing needs of its tribe. Here are some specific tribal initiatives and upcoming events. The Standing Rock Sioux Tribe hosted a training that was sponsored by the North Dakota Housing Finance Agency and the South Dakota Housing Development Authority about the development of supportive housing for the chronically homeless. In fact, we were talking just a moment ago about how interesting it is for a reservation that straddles both North and South Dakota to compare how each state interacts with the tribe and housing initiatives. Another tribal initiative, the Oglala Sioux Tribe, is moving forward with Native Success in a plan to build a 32-unit housing complex specifically for homeless veterans and their families. Thunder Valley Community Development Corporation has an initiative to build straw bale homes to bring more energy efficient and sustainable housing to the Pine Ridge Indian Reservation and continues to work with a sustainable community planning program offered through Housing and Urban Development. Sichangu Wichote Awayankapi, Sichanjo Oyate Tipi received a Supportive Service for Veterans Families Award in 2012. Sichangu Oyate Tipi plans to serve approximately 80 participant households in Gregory, Lyman, Millette, Tripp, and Todd counties and will provide supportive services for veterans who may be homeless or are on the verge of being homeless. The Rosebud Sioux Tribe has a modern 33,000 square foot facility, which I have toured, in which they build homes for any potential buyer within or outside the reservation. The facility is has been built with tribal dollars only and is a product of the Sichangu Wichote Awayankapi housing entity. Now, I won't challenge any of you to show your American Sign Language if you don't challenge me. JR can only do so much to you. Can thank you for your help. As a result of this effort, the Ojiji Wasta, no, excuse me, Ojiji Kapta Housing Development Corporation was created as a wholly owned subsidiary with the purpose of accessing outside housing development markets. And the purpose, of course, is to bring business to the reservation, creating employment for people of Rosebud, and also to create housing. This has come to reality with a recent partnership with Custom Touch Homes out of Madison, South Dakota. And the goal during the first year is to develop up to 70 homes to be sold to the off-reservation market. The capability of the facility is an expansion to 3 employment shifts, providing the market is available. In conjunction with the Custom Touch Homes, the partnership currently employs 25 personnel. Another project is the Dakota Housing Needs Pilot Project Coalition. It consists of tribally designated housing entities for Cheyenne River, Oglala, Rosebud, Lower Brule, and Turtle Mountain Band of Chippewa to jointly address housing needs. And this group is working with the South Dakota Housing Development Authority to conduct the homeless count for their respective areas this week. The Standing Rock Housing Authority constructs and manages over 650 homes for tribal members living on the reservation and is looking into using Habitat for Humanity homes and the government home grant project. Standing Rock has successfully worked with North Dakota and South Dakota housing finance authorities to complete approximately 20 housing projects under the federal low-income housing tax credit program. Another project, the Sisseton-Wahpeton-Oyate, is engaged in the ongoing home inventory tracking system project. Communities within Sisseton-Wahpeton are entered into base maps and then become part of the larger tracking and reporting system, which allows for aid in discussion regarding housing expansion, help identifying weaknesses in existing sanitation and water systems, and providing a means for the Sisseton-Wahpeton-Oyate to ensure an accurate means to justify needed water and wastewater system improvement. Finally, the South Dakota Housing Development Authority is working with tribes in South Dakota to gather more accurate information in regards to housing needs and homelessness. Through the years, the South Dakota Housing Development Authority has partnered with tribal and nonprofit agencies in developing or rehabbing over 820 housing units with an investment over $70 million. In addition to that, there have been 238 governor's houses placed within 29 tribal communities. All of these efforts are excellent and worthy of our praise, whether initiated by a state government or a tribal government. Let's all give the people involved a round of applause and thank them for their efforts. Thank you all for being here today.
Thank you, Governor, for that. Those very good words. I look around this room here today and I see friends. I see people that I've worked with, that I've gone to for advice, to consult with, and to help me tackle issues. I just want to let everybody know you are amongst friends today. Among our friends is the Chief Justice of our Supreme Court of the State of South Dakota. Chief, it's good to see you. Judge Myron, one of our Circuit Court judges, our South Dakota Attorney General, our Lieutenant Governor, Matt Michaels, all of our legislators, members of our State Tribal Relations Committee, right here in front, folks in a balcony. We're all friends. And together we can make South Dakota a better place. And the examples that the governor shared are exactly examples of that, of things that we've done together to make things better. So it's really an exciting day today. But I would be remiss if I did not invite my elder to the stage here to help us call upon the Creator as we start this dialogue and as we continue this dialogue. So at this time, I would like for Father Tuhawk to come forward and offer a word of prayer, blessing on all of us. And then I'm going to ask him, because he's worn so many hats over the years, for those of you, and I don't think any of you don't know Father Tuhawk, but Webster Tuhawk Sr. was born on the Rosebud Reservation in South Dakota in 1930. He's an enrolled, full-blooded Sechongu Lakota. He graduated from Mission High School. He went on to graduate in 1952 with a Bachelor of Science degree in Business Administration from the University of South Dakota. He holds a Master of Divinity from Kenyon College in Ohio and is a veteran, along with my father, of the Korean War. From 1957 until 1968, he served as an Episcopal priest on the Yankton and Standing Rock reservations. He was twice elected president of the Rosebud Sioux Tribe, serving from 1969 to 1973 and from 1983 to 1985. He served as the hospital administrator for the Rosebud Indian Health Service from 1976 to 1982. He worked for the Aberdeen Indian Health Service from 1985 to 1994. And from 1996 to 2003, he worked for the governor of South Dakota as the commissioner for the Tribal Government Relations Office. Now retired, he serves as a volunteer priest for the Episcopal Church, and he's where he's served since 1968. And of course, behind all his accomplishments is a very accomplished woman, his wife, Marge Tuhawk. Let's give Father Tuhawk a round of applause.
I am thankful to be invited back to the Capitol today. I want to thank the governor for the list that you have read, accomplishments of tribal people in the state. Also, I consider a friend, Lieutenant Governor Michaels. He's here too. And then, of course, the state legislative people here too. I know some of you, I may not remember your names, but I remember your faces. Some of them got a little grayer, but nevertheless, you're here. And of course, all the people here, and then the chairman, the representatives from the tribes, thank you very much for coming here too. It's an honor to be invited. I never go any place unless I'm invited. And that's an honor to be invited. And there's a lot going on that we need to share. So many times we share the negatives. But this also, today we heard about some positives, which I really appreciate to hear. And I want to thank, of course, the tribal chairmen, tribal council people who are here, and then the youth. That's something that I know the governor has worked with in the past too. So I too have always been interested in trying to help the youth to go where they need to go with education and have a quality of life that somebody mentioned here before. And then of course I like to eat. So I want to thank the Pro Start people here for bringing food, and I'm afraid it might be getting cold, so I'm going to cut it short. But I'm going to say a prayer for working together in unity. I'll say it in my language. For that of all people relating to each other. Indeed, when I usually say my first words were mitakuyepi na mitakolapi, my friends and relatives, and that's what you are. A lot of you are my friends who are here, and a lot of you, most of you are my friends. But I always say working together makes us come closer, and that way we have a common purpose. But we cannot do that without the help of each other and with the help of the man from above, or the power from above, our Creator. So I'd like to offer a prayer in Lakota, thanking him for the history of our people here together, and I will ask that we will work together in the future for common good of all people, of all colors, and we have them here in South Dakota too, which I think we as cultural people understand we have four colors, and then we have them all. So if you will bear with me, I know my wife is going like this down there, so I better start praying. And this is a privilege, mitakuyepi and mitakolapi, to be asked to pray. And that's something that we always do as Lakota people, as well as I've served Naninin congregations. So it's something that I guess I am a chaplain no matter where I go, and I thank God for that. Togashila wakantaka. Ake mititakuyepi na mitakolaop unshia. Neochla tuhina jipi. Hoi chuha, we chose on a kihet hogahe, health. Chuanaku Eawashi Na Wonspe Wisdom Henat Hokahia Hechet Hokatakia Oyateki Washi Industry and Jobs Taku Kiuha Hena Unkuap in a Awashi Chungo Picti Hechel Wakhantaka Taku Hina near Nishnala Nitha Uyakupi Ochanketa Hena Unkupi Natana Heno Yoniha Hechel Yuha Takun Uyupi Picti. And so, in closing, Heavenly Father, I just ask for my relatives here standing before you that we will have the courage to work together the interest that we have for human beings of all people, so we will accomplish great things in the days to come with this state of South Dakota, with our reservations, wherever we live. This we ask all in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Mitaku yasi. Ohechetu.
Thank you, Father Tuhawk. This time I want to give our tribal leaders an opportunity to say a few words to you. I'm really privileged to have President Steele, or President Brewer, here with us today. President Brewer came all the way from Pine Ridge. He just got in a recent car accident. You might have read about it in a newspaper. And I really admire him because he came all the way up here, and he still has a separated hip that needs to get healed up before they can operate on him. President Brewer, thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy schedule. And would you please share a few words with us?
Thank you, Mr. LaPlante. I'd like to thank the governor, Lieutenant Governor, for having this day. You know, I spent a good part of my life as an educator, working with the Lakota Nation Invitational for the last 37 years. And one of our goals, a gentleman by the name of Chuck Cooney and myself, one of our goals was reconciliation. And that's always been something behind everything we've done. Now I have the opportunity as the tribal president to continue this on a much higher level. And I can't thank you enough for inviting the tribes to come and open up the dialogue with the state. But you don't realize you've also brought the tribes together. You're bringing our circle of brothers together. And this is something that we have to take advantage of. We have to work together. I would like to, I see some of my friends out here, some of our representatives, Mr. Lucas, Mr. Killer, Mr. Heinert, and I'm sure there's some others that I'm missing here. But I would like to thank, Mr. Bradford, Jim Bradford. I can't forget Jim. I would have been in bad trouble if I forgot you. But I would like to thank all of you for having us here and opening up some doors for us. You know, we're all brothers and sisters. The reservations were created to segregate us and keep us away from the population of the state of South Dakota. That's why they were created. And I thank you for opening up some doors, maybe breaking down some barriers for all of us. But I want to thank the governor again, and I thank all of you, and I'm looking forward to working with all of you. And I do this with a good handshake. Ha wopila, mitake ase.
Thank you, President Brewer. And you would have been in trouble if you didn't recognize Senator Bradford. I've been chewed out a number of times for not letting him know I'm on the Pine Ridge Reservation. that won't happen again. At this time, I'd like to call upon council member from Crow Creek Sioux Tribe, and I know the chairman's here somewhere, but because I couldn't locate him, I asked Eric Big Eagle. Is he here? Is the chairman? So I'm gonna ask Councilmember Big Eagle to come up and say a few words. Thank you.
I get the pleasure of following up Brian Brewer. Thank you, Mr. President. As I'd like to just say on behalf of the Crow Creek Sioux Tribe, we'd like to thank the Governor, Lieutenant Governor, Secretary LaPlante, for putting this together and hosting us today. What I've seen today is the start of a process. We've talked about unity and working together. President Brewer touched on the tribes meeting each other and seeing each other here at these events. It's very important to see each other and start a dialogue and work together. The establishment of this tribal and state relationship is very important. We can help each other in many areas. And I see these events as just a starting point for many good things. Again, a very big thank you to the state, and thank you.
Thank you, and he's a great ice fisherman too. And has shared many a walleye with me. Thank you so much. I'd also like to call on Ron Brownotter, who comes from the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe. He's a council member. And on the South Dakota side of the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe, by the way, Standing Rock had become a little bit too North Dakota-centric, and I said that this morning, but they forget they are partly in South Dakota, too. So Ron comes from that area. In fact, he has been designated by Chairman Murphy, and he sends his apologies, by the way. They had a death in the community of a very well-respected tribal official, and so he stayed home to attend those proceedings. But Ron has been designated as the South Dakota liaison for the tribal council, so it's an honor to have him here today. Ron.
Good afternoon. My name is Ron Brownotter. I'm from the community of Bullhead, South Dakota, born and raised on the Standing Rock Indian Reservation on the South Dakota site. It's interesting to see the... We were up at North Dakota about a week or 10 days ago. The North Dakota Governor Dalrymple and the legislatures invited us out there, and they did a whole welcoming, and we met with the legislators that night at a banquet and got to talk, and I think that I didn't have a speech, so I'm just going by my cuff, you know. But God works through people. I've learned that in my life. No matter where you go, what you do, God works through people. God, when you're ready, God will bring the right people at the right time. So it doesn't matter. Good people working with other good people get things done. That's what I've learned. And education is a big number one in my family's life. I'm a product of my reservation, going through first through eighth, and also boarding school at St. Joseph's Indian School. Graduate of Crow Creek Reservation High School back in 1981, and I did 10 years in the Marines, and got to meet a lot of people and a lot of different from all over the country. And when you're in the Marines, rules are not really. You know, you don't have to always go by the rules to get the job done. I've learned that. So sometimes we just, whatever it takes to accomplish the mission, we do it. And that's my attitude today. This is my third term on a council, and I love where I live, and I'm glad this is happening today, the tribal relations working together. Because through partnerships, that's how we get things done. And with the help of God, that's no one can stop that. No bad person or evil person or whatever their position can stop that. And good always comes out, and good conquers evil. That's what I know. And I'm just happy to be here, and didn't think I was going to talk here. I was waiting for the other two councilmen to show up, but they kind of disappeared, so I don't know. I was standing back there, and JR said, I want you to come over here. So I was like, okay, I knew what I was in for, so that's why I'm here. Thank you.
I love my friends so much, that's what I put them through. One of our longest serving tribal chairmen is with us today, and it's really an honor for me to any time I spend visiting with this gentleman, I glean so much knowledge and so much information. I just want to welcome Chairman Michael Jandrew to the stage at this time, if he could share a few words with us.
Thank you, Governor, Lieutenant Governor, First Lady, legislators, fellow tribal members, and even you, Casey. You know, a lot of words are said today about the need to work together, the need to develop South Dakota for all of us. But you know, sometimes when we go away from these occasions, that kind of slips our mind. We've got to refocus ourselves that we're all South Dakotans. And the best part of the South Dakota is the reservations. They're gems that have not been polished. They're deposits of gold that have not yet been mined. I mean that figuratively, not literally. I didn't want you guys to get your picks and shovels ready. But the future is there. There are so many opportunities for the development of South Dakota. If interaction between the tribes and the state of South Dakota and its entire citizenry can really be engaged. South Dakota is a beautiful place, and it can be made more glorious by our real interaction. Not just facades or ideals that we spout and we don't capture here within our heart and our spirit. We can be the perfect example for the rest of this country. We can turn back the pages that have kept us apart and rewrite the book. It is so necessary that we commit ourselves to that. Without that commitment, we will be talking about the same subject 100 years from now. We don't need that to happen. We've been able to engage with each other on business activities, on development activities, on real needs. But the engagement has been so peripheral, it needs to become more intense so that we can all survive. If we do that, we will become great. If we don't, we will lose ourselves. Thank you.
You know, sometimes when I get up public speaking, I always have these women, it's always women, that are watching me, and they'll make eye contact with me, and you can feel them, and I start gravitating, and then I can see that look in their eyes, you're not saying the right thing. And I start panicking, and I'm like, oh no, I'm saying something wrong, and I got something wrong, and I wrongfully introduced Eric Big Eagle to you. He's not merely a council member, he is the vice chairman of the Crow Creek Sioux Tribe, and so, Mr. Vice Chairman, I apologize for that. We can't all be perfect. It's been such a wonderful agenda, but I want to give Marty, would you like to say a few words? Chief, would you like to say a couple words real quickly? And then the legislators will have to break and head out back to session, so they're not trying to be rude, but they got to get back to work. But I do want to give our dancers, since they came from such a long distance, to at least come and dance one grand entry song. And but Marty, go ahead. Our chief, you first.
Thank you. There's been a lot of talk about one-on-one relationships being the foundation of success. And for those of you who don't know, my hometown is Sisseton. And a good friend of mine is here today, Casey Russell, and he taught me a severe lesson of humility, because we used to play tennis together every week, and he always won. So thank you, Casey, for the lesson on humility, I think. The key legislative proposal this session deals with alternative sentencing. Instead of sending people to the penitentiaries, looking at better ways to do things, such as curing the underlying problem that got them there in a lot of cases, that being addiction to drug or alcohol. One of the programs that hasn't gotten a lot of publicity but is an outstanding success is currently going on at Sisseton. If a tribal member comes into state court, rather than being sent to the penitentiary for a addiction-type felony, they are sent to the tribal alcohol program. And I talked to Judge Flemmer this morning, the state judge, who oversees the program from the state side, and he rates it as an outstanding success. These are people who are staying in the community, dealing with their addictions, and hopefully returning to their community to be productive citizens. They say that a long journey begins with one step, and as the state of South Dakota goes into the step of the journey of alternative sentencing, this is a minor or a major step that hopefully will grow into further cooperative agreements around the state. So thank you for your time.
Thank you, Chief. I just want to say, you know, this, I will say this at the end, but I just want to recognize Mark. Mark was in a budget hearing this morning, but he's with the South Dakota Housing. He would have been there this morning. Mark, I just wanted to acknowledge you. Marty?
Thank you, Mr. Secretary, and welcome from the Attorney General's office. I found early on when I was a young U.S. attorney, before I had all this gray hair, that Father Tuhok gave good advice before I went in front of the council, and so I will take his advice that he likes to eat and the food's getting cold, and I'll promise you I'll be brief. But I do want to emphasize the development of continuing relations in law enforcement to better protect tribal members and non-tribal members. I think it starts with the Law Enforcement Training Commission. There now is a commission that has a tribal member on it that makes decisions on what all law enforcement officers should have for a curriculum and what rules they should abide by. We've seen a great partnership in the Sex Offender Registry, where the tribal jurisdictions maintain their own Sex Offender Registry. They maintain control of that, but they've partnered with the state of South Dakota so that all of South Dakota is protected. Time and time again, we see with law enforcement task forces, tribal law enforcement and state law enforcement standing side by side to better protect themselves and your communities. And lastly, you've heard from the Chief Justice about the criminal law initiative that is through the leadership of the Chief Justice and the governor that will better respect the fact that we do have 9 separate sovereign tribes in the state of South Dakota, and better improve that public safety across the board. With that, thank you for allowing me to be your Attorney General, and I hope that we can continue to work to improve law enforcement. Thank you.
Well, I know that was a very quick program. We have limited time, and I know the legislators got to get back to work. I want to say hi to all you guys, and thanks for coming out, Bernie, and all you guys up there. Representative Shrimp, thanks for coming down. He serves up by Eagle Butte on the Cheyenne River Reservation. Just good to see everybody. This has really been a great day. By the way, don't you think the governor did a good job with his Lakota language? Huh? Tuwok, you're going to have to be his teacher from now on, because I'm not the best teacher, but I do my best. Good to see you, Ryan. Rosetta Stone. Rosetta Stone. Well, I just gave him a quick lesson right before we got started. I thought he did a great job. And that's all it's about. You know, we're all trying to learn from each other. Let's keep trying to learn from each other moving forward, not just today, but in the days coming. Let me just thank our sponsors and some of our people that have helped out. I want to thank my staff, first of all. Thank you for all the work that you've done. Governor and First Lady, thanks for hosting that wonderful breakfast this morning. The cooking service, the people that have provided the food and cooked the food this morning was the Laura Brule Pro Start Culinary Arts Program. Thanks, guys, for all your hard work. Joshua Zena Tribal School, dancers and singers, they're going to be here. They're going to be giving you a brief entertainment here. The kitchen provided for us by Lutheran Memorial Church. I want to thank the church for making their kitchen space available so that we could cook today's meal. The buffalo meat that you're going to be eating today was provided by Intertribal Bison Co-op in Rapid City. South Dakota Housing, for all you did with providing help. Lakota Thrifty Mart, a tribally owned enterprise on the Cheyenne River Reservation, for their donations and for the water and the food ingredients. South Dakota Department of Tourism for helping us with our printing again and our wonderful invitation cards. The Bureau of Information, BIT, and Bureau of Information Technology for getting all our stuff on our website, help us get the word out. South Dakota Public Radio, thank you for covering our event. I'm really grateful to these guys. They've really helped us get the word out on the things that we're doing. And then Rosebud Sioux Tribe Legislative Affairs Office, Lewis and Damon, you guys, thanks for all your help and always working with us. Palamaya Hilo Pidamaya, thank you. It's been a wonderful day, and we're going to conclude today's event with some singing and dancing from the Teoshpa Zena Tribal School singers and dancers. And after that, join us for a meal. Thank you. Have a very nice day. Okay, you ready? Where's our arena director? Okay. Arena director, wave your hand if you're ready. See, I try to be a good Palawan T. Wave your hand, arena director, if you're ready. There he goes. Okay, hokahe. Thank you. Hold on. Let me introduce you. These dancers came all the way from Sisseton, Wahpeton, and the first one is the fancy shawl dancer. Is that Lily? No? Oh, jingle dress is Lily Mae Smith. And Tate Lafferty? Laughter. Tate Laughter. And our fancy shawl dancer is Annie Durkin. And what are we doing next, Arena Director? Oh, we're going to have a round dance, right? Round dance. Okay. So this is a participatory dance, right? So anybody can join us. If you don't have rhythm, that's okay, because I know half of you don't have rhythm anyway. Okay. So you guys go ahead. We're going to have a round dance, and these boys are going to come up here. What are their names?
Jacob LaPlante.
Jacob LaPlante. And Chante Eastman.
Johnny German.
And Johnny German are our singers. And they're going to be using a hand drum today. And this takes a lot of talent to be able to sing and drum at the same time. Most of us can't rub our head and pat our belly at the same time. These guys are going to sing and play hand drum at the same time. And this is a traditional round dance, or what we often call a friendship dance. So feel free to join in this circle. And before I start the music, Father Lyle, good to see you, Father. Thanks for coming out today, all the way from Great Gree, South Dakota. Thank you, Father. Okay, hokahe. Free to join in. You don't have to be the best dancer. Hello, Gina, how you doing? Representative Heinert brought his family today. Good to see you guys all the way from Mission, South Dakota. You're the only one for me. Did you hear those lyrics? You're the only one for me. That's a true love song, I tell you. Takes me back to my dating days. Governor. for bringing your drum and your dancers and all your songs. First Lady, thank you. Thank you so much. Legislators, I know you got to get back to work. Thank you for coming out. I want to thank everybody. Safe travels. And let me put in a plug for the Great Plains. Are the South Dakota Indian Country Lawyers Association. Is that right? South Dakota Indian Country Lawyers Association is having their first conference tomorrow here in Pierre. You can find information about that on our website. Okay, the meal is ready. And so we got plenty of soup, plenty of fry bread, plenty of wojabi. Enjoy a good meal. Have a great day. Don't forget to check out the booths that are going to be set up here in the rotunda. God bless you. Have a good rest of the day.